Yeah. So hello everyone, this is Varish here and welcome to Animals and Their Young Ones Day 1. So we are in a new chapter. In previous chapters we learned about ionic charge, we learned about nutrition in plants, we learned matter and we know what are acids, bases and salts. Now in this video we are going to deal with animals and their young ones. So basically, when we hear the title, we need to know, we get an idea that, okay, in this chapter, we are going to deal with various kinds of animals, various kinds of birds which are there, and how they feed the young ones, and various things, their life cycles and all that stuff. We learn about a polar bear, a penguin, a whale, many things, right? So, let's begin this very, very interesting chapter. This deals with the world of living beings. Okay, starting with, in our chapter, Nutrition in Plants, we know that all living beings have the ability to reproduce and this process is called reproduction. So basically, there is a living being on this earth and this living being, it has the ability to produce a living being of its same kind. Suppose there is a giraffe, it has the ability to produce the giraffe of the same kind. Suppose there is a polar bear, the polar bear has the ability to produce another polar bear of its same kind. Suppose there is a human, a female human has the ability to produce its child, which is also human. So all living things, any living thing, even a plant has the capability of producing. But in this chapter, we are not going to talk about plants. We are only going to talk about animals. Animals in the sense, all the animals present, humans and stuff. So all animals have the ability to reproduce and this process is called reproduction. That's as simple as it is. And even plants. So even some animals can give birth, some animals can lay eggs. Before we get into that, this point is what we have a clarity now. All living things have the ability to reproduce. Now this is what keeps the species alive and continues their species. So suppose there is a giraffe, let's imagine life was created by some Big Bang theory and stuff. So when life was created, suppose there is the first giraffe on the planet, there is the giraffe, it has born and it's just created, let's imagine it, and it doesn't have a capability of reproducing, and after it dies, there won't be any more giraffes unless and until another one is created by magic or something. But no, because there won't be any other kind of giraffe. So that is the reason all living things have reproduction to continue their species. But some species are becoming extinct because dinosaurs, they have a meteorite. A theory for them, and some are, because we are killing some animals, they are becoming endangered and some are becoming extinct. So that's what is about reproduction. Now there are two ways in which you can reproduce or produce a species of the same kind. One is you can give birth, or from your body another body is coming and you can lay eggs. An egg is nothing but, an egg is a structure from which another living organism comes out. Animals like giraffe, humans, elephants, they, from their bodies, another body comes, they give birth. Whereas some birds, insects, reptiles, they just lay some structures called eggs. From these eggs, their offsprings come. So next is giving birth to young ones. Now let's deal with this. Animals which give birth to young ones are called mammals. Now we have got a complete definition of what a mammal is. So this means that as humans give birth, they are mammals. As polar bears give birth, they are mammals. As penguins give birth, as whales give birth, they are mammals. As lions give birth, they are mammals. And as horses give birth, they are mammals. As cows give birth, they are mammals. So there are many mammals. Now, there are two types as we learned, giving birth to young ones, they are called mammals, and egg-laying species. So some features of mammals or the organisms which give birth to young ones are: mammals have lungs to breathe. Now humans have lungs to breathe, polar bear has lung to breathe, etc. Mammals are warm-blooded, that is, their body temperature doesn't change with the temperature of the surroundings. So as we know, warm-blooded animals and cold-blooded animals, we are warm-blooded. Or let's have a good definition of warm-blooded animals, that is, the temperature in our surroundings is constantly changing. It can be hot, it can be cold, but our body temperature doesn't change. So we are warm-blooded animals. Similarly, polar bear lives in the Antarctic regions. It's very cold out there, but its body temperature doesn't change. It's a warm-blooded animal. Their bodies are covered with hair. Now, every mammal, like elephants, have hair on them. Even we have hair on us. The polar bears have hair on them, etc. The amount of hair or the quantity of hair varies, but we all have hair. All mammals have a hair. Mammals have well-developed hair and external ears. Now, even we have external ears, as we see polar bear has external ears. Even we have external ears. Yeah, mothers feed their young ones with milk. Now, when you generally observe animals, like elephants, basically, if you have observed it, then the young elephant is below the elder elephant. That means the elder elephant is feeding the young elephant with milk. So that is the most important characteristic present. Next, they show parental care. Examples are cow, goat, horse, lion, human, etc. They're all mammals. Now, here are two interesting facts. One thing, bats can fly like birds but give birth to babies and are mammals. So generally, birds are animals which fly and they lay eggs. But bats are also like birds which fly, but they produce a living being from their body. They give birth. So they are mammals. That is one big fact. And second thing, whales and dolphins look like fish but give birth and are mammals. So basically, fish which are there, they also lay eggs. But the dolphins, the cute dolphins present, and the whales, they look like fish. Yeah, but they don't lay eggs. They give birth. So they are mammals. So from this we learned that one important thing, giving birth to young ones are called mammals. That's it. And they have certain various properties and features which we discussed about. Now let's go to egg-laying animals. Now this is the most important part of a chapter, because here we learn something about life cycles. Okay, so for now we know what is a mammal and how reproduction takes place, there are two types and stuff. So now let's see. Animals like birds, insects, frogs and reptiles lay eggs and are called egg-laying animals. This is very simple. The animals which lay eggs are called egg-laying animals. Okay, so the process in which a baby develops into a young one is called life cycle. So what happens, a baby which is there, it is developing into a young one. That is called a life cycle, the cycle of life. How the organism is going through its different stages. That's called a life cycle. And now we learn about different life cycles in this chapter. In our next parts, so like the life cycle of a bird, a butterfly, a cockroach, a frog, etc. So there are life cycles. Even we, from a baby, we start. We get some 9 to 10 years, we are tweens, and then we become teens, and then we become youths, we become adults, and then we become old people. So that's our life cycle. Similarly, every organism has a life cycle which we need to know about, because they have very, very, very interesting life cycles. So that's what we'll deal in the next video. But now I guess we have a clarity about how will organisms reproduce, how they give birth, and how they lay eggs. Now let's see one more important thing, the structure of a hen's egg. Now a hen lays eggs. What is the structure of that egg? All birds have the same egg structure. That is what we know. Second thing, now let's learn the parts of the egg. The outer protective hard shell is called the eggshell. Now this one, The outer protective, the outer part or the outer covering of the shell is known as the eggshell. It protects the part inside. So basically, if you take anything, even if you take a cell, there is a cell wall or a cell membrane that protects the cell. So that is why any outer layering is just for protection. Next, inside the cell, the white jelly-like substance is called albumin. It is rich in proteins and protects the yolk and embryo. So this white part which is present, it's called the albumin. It's a jelly-like substance. So that means it is very, it's very soft and jelly-like substance, bumpy stuff. And it is very rich in proteins and it protects the yolk and the embryo. Now, what is the yolk? The yolk is the yellow part. So it obviously, as it is a soft covering for the yolk, it is protecting it, right? And yolk is the central yellow portion and food for the embryo. Now, the yolk which is present, it is a yellow color ball-like structure, and it is the food for the embryo. Now, embryo is nothing but a growing organ or growing baby. So before we see organism as a baby itself, let it be out of an animal or out of an egg, the first stage before a baby is an embryo. Even in humans, first a embryo develops inside the stomach, inside the body, then it develops into a baby and it comes out. Similarly, in an egg, first the embryo develops, it feeds and it becomes a baby, it develops all its parts and then it comes out of the egg. So that's the process which happens. So the embryo is present inside the yolk. You can see my red color mark. That's where the embryo is present. And this yolk which is there, it's a food for the embryo. And it is very rich in fats, vitamins and minerals. That is why most people consider to eat this egg. So in today's video, we have learned about reproduction and how the reproduction goes on. How animals give birth, what are they call their mammals, and what are some of their properties, and how do animals lay eggs and structure of an egg. So hope you learned something new in today's video. We'll continue the chapter in the next video. In the next videos, what we'll do is we'll learn the life cycles, where it becomes really, really interesting. So hope you like this, and this is going to be our next chapter. Thank you for watching this video. Until then, bye bye.